Hey guys, PhotoshopProHelp here, and today I'm going to be showing you how to create some simple water droplets. So as we can see, these are the droplets that we're going to make, and they're really simple, but they do take quite a lot of settings to get used to. So first things first is I'm going to go and take them off so we can see our original image. So we have this one right here, and then from here what we're going to do is make a new blank layer, bottom right hand side, click the new blank layer icon, and we're just going to go and rename this layer, so we can rename it to anything. So I'm going to name it to bubbles, and what we're going to do next is we're going to go up to our elliptical marquee tool, which is on the top left hand side, and it may be hiding just underneath the rectangle marquee tool, so click and hold and find that. And we're going to hold down shift on our keyboard, and we're going to go and drag out a perfect circle, nothing too big, so around about there for me. And from here we're going to go over to our gradient tool, which is on the left hand side as well, and we're going to go up to the top, which is the drop down menu, and we're going to go and select the third option along, which is black to white. Click that, and we want to make sure that we have the linear gradient clicked on, which is next to the drop down menu. And once you have that selected, we're going to hold down shift again on our keyboard, and we're going to go from the top left hand corner of the circle down to the bottom right hand corner. So drag out just like this, and as we can see, that's black to white, which is quite nice. And from here we're just going to go and double click on this layer, and that brings up the layer styles, so go and double click that. And I already have all of my settings already in for me, so you can go and pause the video at any time and you can go and see all the settings that I'm going to put in, but I will be going through them with you and I will tell you when to pause the video if you want to. So we're going to go down to drop shadow now, and you can pause the video right now if you want to. And for the blend mode, it's going to be multiply, the color is going to be black, the opacity 15%, the angle 135, and use global light clicked on. The distance to the spread and the size is all going to be 4, and for the contour, it's going to be the second option along. So select that, and then we're going to go up to inner glow. So you can pause the video right now, and for the blend mode is going to be multiply, the opacity is going to be 20%, the noise is going to be 0%, the color is going to be set to black. For the elements, we're going to go for the technique of softer, the source is going to be set to edge, choke is 0%, size is 4 pixels, and the quality can be left alone because we don't need to touch that. The next thing is inner shadow, and you can pause the video right now. And from here we're going to go up to blend mode, which is multiply again, color black, opacity 15%, angle 135 with the use global light clicked on, the distance set to 5, choke is set to 0%, size is 5 pixels, and the quality can be left alone just like the other one. We're going to go up to bevel and emboss now, and with these settings right here you do have to play around with them, but I will be telling you a bit about that a bit later. So let's go and have a look. We can pause the video if need be. The style is going to be inner bevel, technique is smooth, depth 205%, direction to up, size to 29 pixels, soften, which is 0 pixels. The shading is going to be an angle of 135 and use global light clicked on. The altitude is 69. Gloss contour can be left alone. The highlight mode is set to normal, opacity 100% and the color to white. The shadow mode is overlay, the opacity 90% and the color white again. From here, we do need to play around with 3 different settings within the bevel and emboss. So if I go and zoom in on our little water droplet, we can see this little white shine, which is quite nice. So we're going to go back to our settings, and from here we can see that we have the depth, the size and the angle, and they're the 3 main ones that we do need to play around with. So all of those 3 settings are going to change this little white mark here, and we want it to around about this. So you're going to have to play around with it depending on the size of your actual water droplet and how big you've made the actual circle. It will vary, so play around with it, see if you can get it to around about there. It does take quite a lot of fiddling, but it is pretty easy to get used to. So once you have played around with the depth, the size and the angle, click OK. And the next thing we're going to do is we're going to go up to the blend mode of this layer. So go down to the drop down menu, which is on the right hand side, and we're just going to go down to overlay. So as we can see, the bubble has disappeared and it has become see-through, and we're just going to go and press Ctrl and D to deselect, and we can go and move this bubble wherever we want to. So I'm going to move it over the A, and because we have something coming through the bubble, which is a, or we can have a picture coming through or whatever it's going to overlap, what we're going to do is we're going to hold down Ctrl on our keyboard. We're going to go and select the bubble layer, which is the little icon, and that has become selected. Now that we have that, we're going to go and select our bottom layer, which is the main layer of our bottle. From here, we're going to go up to Filter, down to Distort, and over to Ripple. From here, we're going to go and bring the amount up, and as we can see, the A is becoming distorted, which is quite nice. And it really depends on your taste. You have to play around with it. I'm going to go for 449, and then I'm going to go click OK. As we can see, that has been distorted. We can go and press Ctrl and D or Command and D if you have a Mac, and that deselects it. So as we can see, we zoom out and we have our little water droplet. Now what happens if we want to go and change the actual shape of this water droplet? Well, that's pretty easy. So we can go to our bubble layer, and from here we can go and make a duplication. So Ctrl and J or Command and J if you have a Mac, and we're just going to go and move this to somewhere else. And from here, all we're going to do is go up to Filter, we're going to go down to Liquify, and we're just going to go and zoom in on this little black and white dot. So go and zoom in like that, and we're going to go up to the forward warp tool, which is at the top, and we want the size of the brush to be around about the same size as the actual dot. And then from here we can make this any shape that we want. I'm just going to go to something around about there, and I'm going to go click OK. So you can have it anything you want, click OK, and as we can see, it's a different shape, and you can have it as big as you want as well by pressing Ctrl and T or Command and T if you have a Mac to free transform, holding down Shift to keep the aspect ratio, and make it as big or as small as you want. Click the tick icon at the top, and then we can go and place it wherever we want to. So I'm going to go and place it to around about there, and then I'm going to go and zoom out. As we can see, that's pretty effective and really nice. Now sometimes when you do change the shape of it, the little white glow, which can change, and as I said, we just need to go back into the layer style, so double click that layer and go to bevel and emboss and play around with the size, the depth and the actual angle. Once you've done that, click OK, and that's all you need to know. So apart from that, guys, I hope you liked this tutorial. Please comment, rate and subscribe. Please go check out the website, Facebook and Google+. And if you want to support me, go check out the new t-shirts from Photoshop Pro Help. The link will be after this video, so stay tuned for that. And I'll see you next time, guys. Bye for now.